Hello YouTubers, how's it going? TK42138 here, and just going to have a look inside the cargo area of the Nissan X-Trail, T30 Nissan X-Trail. As you can see, it's a sport DCI. So, first things first, the dog guard is not standard with the car. Got this from Halfords about 2 years ago. Very good design, because it clips around the rear seat rests, the headrests, and there's still room to get the parcel shelf underneath the frame. So, basically, what's in my boot, or if you're watching this in the States, the trunk. So you've got the jack and handle just there. Always have one of these in the car, good for holding shopping bags in the back. Just dog bags, dog poop bags. Obviously, first aid kit, and these are the spare bolts for the dog guard. Put this lot back. One of my followers mentioned that they're getting a lot of noise and creaks and flexing of the load bed on one of these, and so I decided to have a look, see if there's a potential problem on my own one, and just see if we can share information. So in order to lift this up, push this down and lift. Right, as you can see, it's strong, but it flexes a bit, which seems a bit of a contradiction. But it's made of, I think, ABS plastic. It's got these strengthening ribs in it, but they're not very deep section, so there is a bending moment, or bending, as you can see. It will flex. There might be a way around that, but we'll have a look at that in a moment. This one just pulls out. To reduce creaking, I use just a heavy duty dustbin bag, a trash bag, and I put that between the special foam styrene insert and the actual floor plate. Lift out the insert. And then you've got one full-size spare wheel. And because there's a gap between the insert and the structure, you can fit various bits around it. Yep, more antifreeze coolant. Yeah, screen wash. Right, so the problem with this is it's plastic and it flexes if you put too much load on it. And I thought that was a crack, but it's not. So these ridges here, they're strengtheners, they're ribs, but they're not very deep in cross section, so that's why it will flex. But there's a way around it. Bearing in mind that the floor sits flat on this recess, let me just show you. There's not much room there for adding extra strengthening ribs because you've got these inserts. Plus also, thickness of the floor, the removable panel. It can't be any higher than this, otherwise it will catch when you're loading stuff. And it's, if it's thinner, again, it will be even more flexible. So the only real way of improving the rigidity that I can see, bearing in mind you've got a spare wheel under here, is to either remove the spare wheel and carry an emergency tyre inflator system. So then, without this here, then you'll be able to put thicker ribs, strengthening ribs, on the actual panel. But I want to keep the spare wheel there because it's obviously a spare. The only other way, if you're going to be carrying heavy loads, is to cut a piece of marine grade plywood so it fits all the way round the load area, and you sit it on top of this. That's the only way I can see how to keep, or how to remove the chance of it flexing. It just means you'll be carrying an extra sheet of timber around. I'm trying to do this one-handed, as you can imagine, not easy. So that just sits. That sits flush on there. And see, that's the thing. There are no latches to hold this down. So if you hit a bump, if you're not carrying anything in the back, and you hit, you're on a bumpy road or anything, this can start moving about. It's a shame in a way. There's not a sort of positive locking structure mechanism actually on the panel, because then that would keep any vibration to a minimum. Right, well, I'm going to think about possible ways of making the removable floor panel, giving it a more positive locking action. At the moment, it's just its own weight that holds it down, plus whatever's sitting on it. So I'm going to give that some thought. Thanks for watching. Hope it's been useful. Don't forget to rate, comment, share, subscribe for more videos. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.